Douglas Fairbanks Jr. was one of the great cinematic swashbuckling swordsmen of all times. He starred in The Prisoner of Zenda, The Corsican Brothers, Sinbad the Sailor, and 70 other movies. Now, over 40 years later, he's back again to give lessons in swordsmanship, or so the publicity blurb says, to Paul Nicholas, who's about to play the lead role in what, so the publicity blurb says, is a pulsating production of The Pirates of Penzance, which has simply decimated the critics' stocks of superlatives when it was part of New York Shakespeare Festival. There wasn't too much pulsating going on at today's press photo call, though. There was just actually a lot of posing, rather to the bemusement of some of the locals. Or perhaps it was just the two stars who were rather bemused. Because, trained observer that I am, it struck me that although his spirit may be willing, Sir Douglas Fairbanks' body, fine-looking as it is at 80-something in age, simply couldn't anymore teach Paul Nicholas, 30-something, how now to buckle a proper swash.
Has the hand, the old hand, lost its cunning after all these years?
Oh, I suppose it has, yes. It would be at anything, whether it's golf or tennis or fencing or anything, of course. It needs a lot of practice to get back in shape. You can show off for about 3 minutes and then you're stuck.
What will you actually be teaching, Paul?
I shouldn't think anything. You'd probably teach me. I don't really know till the time comes.
But surely the publicity blurb said he was here to give Paul lessons in swordsmanship.
Are you actually expecting to give him any kind of instruction?
I'm not expecting anything till I hear. I think it's unwise to expect. I just look forward to seeing what they do want.
But you are commissioned, as it were, to do something with him, are you?
No, I wouldn't say commissioned. I just, a friend of mine, Paul Elliott, asked me would I do it, and I was here and said, sure, fine.
Well, just the publicity thing today, you mean?
Yes.
But you don't think you will actually be taking this any further with teaching Paul?
Not that I know of. If they ask me to, it depends how much time I have, because I'm going to only be here another couple of days.
It's sometimes said about journalists that they don't like to spoil a good story by telling the truth. That said in jest, of course. But from what Sir Douglas Fairbanks says, I suppose publicists will now sometimes have the same jest told about them too. Christopher Rainbow for Thames News.
How would you like us?